behalf of Estimate Systems, we want to thank you very much for your time and attention.
My co-chair, Patricia McDowell, has requested that we talk about the upper Warburton zone change. I see a couple of people in the audience that spoke at the last public meeting about the upper Warburton zone change. I know that there are a couple of people on the council that had a couple of questions about it. I think those questions have been asked and answered. There may be other people that have some questions, so will you just do that quickly?
Thank you. Good evening, my name is Mike Kurtz, I'm a resident of One David Lane in Yonkers, New York. I'm here to speak regarding the proposal of rezoning of Wolfburton Avenue, and that is specifically all lots in block 3610, and all lots in block 3615, and lots 1 through 20 in block 3570. The community had... All lots in blocks 3610, and blocks in block 3615, those are along the river, from about the Greystone Station up to the city line, they're all on the west side of the railroad tracks. This is the tax map, if that helps. And then it's in block 3570, which actually fronts Wolfburton Avenue, the west side of Wolfburton Avenue, at the top, of course, at the city line. David Lane is east of Wolfburton Avenue and up the hill. Do you see where it says M? M is in Mary?
Yeah.
That's David Lane.
Okay.
That's David Lane. That's in the east district.
Right.
So, all lots, 3610, 3615, lots 1 through 20 in block 3570. The community had submitted petitions for all lots in 3610, 3615, and 3570, all lots. That would include the tower at River Hill Tower 1155. So we petitioned for that. We presented that to the mayor in September 27th of 07. We had CC'd the existing council members. John wasn't on the council at that time, but I believe everyone else was on that petition. And the people who signed that petition were willing to have their zoning changed. The planning department spoke to us. They met with members at 1085 Wolfburton and 1155 Wolfburton. They had discussed the impact of being a non-conforming use. The people in those residences, including their boards, wanted the zone change regardless of becoming a non-conforming use. The city planning board asked to meet with us again, and we had a meeting with Lee Elman, another rep from the planning board, Gary Weinberg, who you probably got to know over the years, Michael Sabatino, myself. We met in the boardroom of 1085. The main issue, in my recollection, why the city was hesitant to rezone as the community had requested, was because at that time the Ginsburg property had approvals, and the affordable housing component in those approvals were being counted in the settlement of the desegregation case. And to make that property non-conforming at that time, even if the existing towers were okay to go non-conforming, had the potential to open up a whole other can of worms, a whole another venue that had really nothing to do with what the community was coming forward. This community's always been supportive of affordable housing.
Sorry, can I just back up to